Yo, what's going on, guys? My name is Deller, and I am back with some Washington Commanders content here. It's not Madden related, it's not college football related, but it is the real Commanders schedule. So we're going to be taking a look at our 2024 Washington Commanders schedule and predicting the win-loss of the schedule. And, you know, the training camp just kicked off today. Today was the first day. I will be going to three different training camps starting this week. I'll be at this Friday's training camp as well. So, but with that training camp starting today, it makes me want to make more actual real-life Commanders content. So if you guys do enjoy this, make sure to hit that like button. It lets me know to keep doing this or not. And if you guys are new, make sure to hit that sub button. We do daily football content over here on my channel. So I am going to be giving you guys three scenarios of the 2024 Commanders schedule. So the first one we're going to be going over is going to be my prediction, like my fan-hearted prediction, which you guys are gonna like not like at all. I already know you guys in the comments, you guys are not gonna like this one whatsoever. And then the one after this one, we're going to be doing my true realistic opinion on how these are going to be. And then my last one we're going to be doing is our worst comes to worst. We hit rock bottom, you know, schedule is what the absolute bare minimum I believe is, you know, the chance of this schedule. But let's hop in. So week one, we do take on the Tampa Bay Buccaneers in Tampa Bay. And again, this version is my fan-hearted opinion. So obviously me being a fan, I got us taking the W there. I got us going into Tampa Bay, absolutely stuffing Baker Mayfield, clamping Mike Evans. You know, I have us as a fan going in there and beating Tampa Bay. Week two, we got the Giants, our home opener. That's going to be a W. It's home opener. Can't lose that. And it's the Giants. Come on now. I know we lost two times to the Giants last year, but this is a whole different team. This whole new vibes, whole new everything. Week three, Monday Night Football against the Cincinnati Bengals. This is an L. This is an L on all three tiers. I don't see us winning on primetime in the jungle with healthy Joe Burrow, Jamar Chase. Don't see it happening. But week four against the Cardinals in Arizona, got us taking a W there. Kyler Murray, you know, not going to go into that. Have us taking the W there. Week five, we come back home. FedEx Field. Sorry, excuse me. Week five, we come back. Commanders Field. Against the Cleveland Browns, we take a W there. I know you guys, you Brown fans there are fucking pissed. I know it. Week six, we hop on the bus and just take a little, you know, a little 20-minute trip down the road to Baltimore. That's going to be an O on all three tiers. It's in the bank. You know, banks close on Sundays, but we are still the Washington Commanders. Week seven, Carolina Panthers at home. That's a W. Do we even know if the Panthers are like a real team? Do they have a real quarterback? I don't know. That's a W. Bears. Y'all Bears fans don't like me, huh? You guys don't like me. Guess what? We're beating you guys at home. At Commanders Field. You know, that Thursday night football game, that was a fluke. This is the real deal. And then we go right back up to New York, take another W. You know, we go into MetLife Stadium, take a W there. It's the Giants. Come on now, we're going to sweep them. Pittsburgh Steelers come to Commanders Field. They come to the Hogs Pen. Mollywopped. Who's going to be their quarterback? Don't matter. Commanders taking that W. Thursday night football in Philly. I know we beat them there once on primetime. I don't have us beating them again on primetime at their home. Don't have it happening. But we do have the Cowboys at home. That's going to be our first back-to-back loss this season. Cowboys are probably going to be rolling. Dak, CD, they're probably going to be grooving during that time. Just around Thanksgiving time, that's going to be a tough game. But then, very next week, we got Tennessee Titans. Will Levis might be slanging, but he ain't slanging on my team. We got us taking a W there. We got a nice bye week to rest up after being slanged by Will Levis, but still taking the W. And we go into New Orleans against Chase Young, former Washington Commander. SW, come on now. Come on now. Derek Carr's going to throw three picks, two to St. Juice and one to Emmanuel Forbes. And then the Eagles come to a Commander's Field. W. I feel like we could play better against them when we're at home. Did it before, you know, W. And then next week we have the Atlanta Falcons. Will Michael Penix, whatever you want to call him, will he be starting by then? I don't know, but it's going to be a W. And then, you know, lastly, we go to Dallas. That's a W. They're going to be resting all their players, getting ready for the playoffs. You know, they're going to be ready to lose first round and everything. They're going to be resting all their players. We're going to get that W there. And I have us actually going 13-4 as my true heart opinion. As a fan, this is truly what I think. As a fan. Now let's hop into my realistic predictions of this season. Alrighty, so hopping into my realistic Washington Commanders schedule prediction. Now week one, realistically, I think we go into Tampa Bay. I don't think we could get that W. You know, with how, if Baker plays like he did last year with Mike Evans and Godwin, I think that's going to be an L. But we do take a bounce back W as the home opener against the New York Giants. I don't see us really losing that game. I think that's a lock W for us. And then again, like I said in the past, I think this is a locked L. Unfortunately, Monday Night Football against the Cincinnati Bengals, that's going to be a tough game. But then we go to Arizona. I do think we could beat the Arizona Cardinals. It doesn't matter where it is, home or away. I think we can beat them. But then the Browns come in, and I do think the Browns take the W here. I mean, it's very up in the air. I think it's very up in the air. I think depending on which quarterback is kind of feeling themselves by week five, that's going to be whatever team wins. Obviously, Deshaun Watson, I used to love Deshaun Watson so much, but I just feel like he is not a good quarterback anymore, and I just don't feel him doing anything at all. But I'll give you guys the benefit of the doubt. You guys have the better defense, obviously. I don't know. I feel like our offense could keep up, but I'm going to give you guys the Browns W there. Jayden Daniels might still be, you know, trying to get stuff rolling there. And then again, taking that ride down to Baltimore, it's going to be an L every single time, unfortunately. And then coming back home for the Panthers, that's a W. I feel like that's a locked W as well. I think we could I don't want to say easily, because, you know, we still are the Commanders. They still are the Panthers. But I think that's, you know, I think we have that game in the bag. I think that's going to be our game. You know, Bears fans can cry all they want. I feel like we're going to beat the Bears as well. Caleb Williams coming back home, he's going to have a lot of pressure on, you know, playing against a home crowd. I think we could beat the Bears there. Again, going to New York, I think that's still another W. I think we sweep the Giants this year, unlike last year where we got swept by the Giants. But then Pittsburgh comes in, and Pittsburgh does beat us. They beat us pretty bad. You know, that's kind of just, you know, pickings on, you know, probably Emmanuel Forbes or St. Juice. I just realistically don't think that will happen. Obviously, I'm cheering for my boys, but, you know. And then we go with Thursday Night Football. Again, that's another one of those locked L's for us. And talking about locked L's, let's go ahead and get the Cowboys one out of the way. Again, I just feel so confident that the Cowboys are just going to be rolling. Same with the Eagles. You know, I feel like those two back-to-back games right there, unfortunately, are kind of given L's, you know, just unfortunately, you know. But then we come back, take a W against the Titans. Again, I am not big on the Titans whatsoever. I do think we can easily take that win there. Obviously, have a nice bye week rest up. And then we go to New Orleans, take the W against the Saints. I think it's a pretty reasonable game there. I feel like we can absolutely beat the Saints there. And then we're going to get swept by the Eagles like we usually do. Unfortunately, that's going to be a tough loss, but I feel like that game's going to be super, super close. So yeah, that game's going to be a loss to the Eagles there. But I do have us beating the Falcons. Again, it doesn't matter what quarterback's in. I do feel like we could personally beat the Falcons. And then same as well here. I feel like we will beat the Cowboys. on that last game of the season. We're known to play really, really well against the Cowboys at the last game when it doesn't really matter. And I do think we're going to win. I feel like they're just, again, going to sit out their starters, and we might have a chance to win that game. So my realistic prediction of the Washington Commanders, realistic season prediction is 9-8. This is what I truly feel like my boys can actually do. No fan bias in here. I truly think that we can, go 9-8 realistically. Alrighty, and now lastly, we're going to be doing my absolute floor for the Washington Commanders. Like, this is like worst comes to worst, you know, the house is on fire, everything is going terribly wrong. I don't have a single thought in my mind that this will actually happen, but I already know that, you know, there's people gonna, you know, say all these types of stuff. So I'm just going to go out there and put it, you know, why not? So this is maybe, I don't know, Jayden Daniels isn't the guy we think he is. You know, we take an L to the Tampa Bay Buccaneers to start it off the season, you know, home opener. Like I said, I think that's a locked W there. I think we will win that game. We're 1-1. We look good, you know? Okay. We lose, obviously, that Monday Night Football locked in, and then we lose to the Cardinals in Arizona. Now we're 1-3. Lose to the Browns. Now we're 1-4. Again, lose to the Ravens. That's a locked L. We're 1-5. We will beat that Panthers, though. Panthers is a locked W, guaranteed. And then realistically, Caleb Williams comes back home and he wants to show his family, you know, that who he is. And then we lose to the Bears. Unfortunately, we split with the Giants, in New York. That's a rough one to bite. That's a rough one to even say. Again, then lose to the Steelers, lose to the Eagles, lose to the Cowboys, beat the Tennessee Titans. I do think we will beat the Titans. I don't think the Titans are that good, especially with no Derrick Henry. Again, somehow lose the bye week. There you go. You're happy about that. Somehow lose to the Saints, lose to the Eagles at home, lose to the Falcons at home. Again, it's just a lot of L's. And then we unfortunately take that L last game of the season versus the Cowboys, which means the absolute lowest I have us going is 3-14, probably up there for the number, you know, 1, 2, 3 pick, hopefully. But this is the absolute lowest. I don't have a single doubt in my mind that any of this will happen. I truly think we'll sneak out some of those tougher W's. This Cardinal ones, I believe, easy W there. Maybe not easy, but I feel like, you know, we could get the W in Arizona. We could get the W in New Orleans. I feel like we're going to sweep the Giants. I feel like we can really beat the Bears. You know, me personally, I truly think we could beat the Steelers. I think we could beat the Falcons. And I feel like we'll split with the Cowboys. But yeah, boys, that has been my, my fan prediction, realistic prediction, and my absolute worst comes to worst predictions of the 2024 Washington Commanders schedule. Again, I'm gonna try to make more videos based off the Commanders. Maybe we'll do definitely gonna do a lot with the theme team, especially with Madden 25 coming up right around the corner. So if you guys are excited for Madden 24, make sure to hit that like button, make sure to hit that sub button to never miss a video, and I'm out of here, man. Peace.